Please stand as you are able. Blessed be God, most holy, glorious, and undivided Trinity. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Glory to you, Lord God of our ancestors. You are worthy of praise. Glory to you. Glory to you for the radiance of your holy name. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you in the splendor of your temple. On the throne of your majesty, glory to you. Glory to you, seated between the cherubim. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. Glory to you, beholding the depths. In the high vault of heaven, glory to you. Glory to you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We will praise you and highly exalt you forever. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, it is only by your gift that your faithful people offer you true and laudable service. Grant that we may run without stumbling to obtain your heavenly promises. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the lessons.
Our first reading is from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses convened all Israel and said to them, "Now this is the commandment, the statutes and the ordinances, that the Lord your God charged me to teach you to observe in the land that you are about to cross into and occupy, so that you and your children and your children's children may fear the Lord your God all the days of your life, and keep all his decrees and his commandments that I am commanding you, so that your days may be long. Hear therefore, Israel, and observe them diligently, so that it may go well with you, and so that you may multiply greatly in a land flowing with milk and honey, as the Lord, the God of your ancestors, has promised you. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. Keep these words that I am commanding you today in your heart. Recite them to your children and talk about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. Bind them as a sign on your hand, fix them as an emblem on your forehead, and write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates." The word of the Lord. Our psalm is Psalm 119. Let's read it responsibly by whole verse. Happy are they whose way is blameless, who walk in the law of the Lord.
Happy are they who observe his decrees and seek him with all their hearts.
Who never do any wrong, but always walk in his ways. Oh, that my ways were made so distinct that I might keep your statutes.
Then I should not be put to shame when I regard all your commandments.
I will thank you with an unfeigned heart when I have learned all your righteous judgments.
I will keep your statutes. Do not utterly forsake me.
Our second reading is from the letter to the Hebrews. When Christ came as a high priest of the good things that have come, then through the greater and perfect tent, not made with hands, that is, not of this creation, he entered once for all into the holy place, not with the blood of goats and calves, but with his own blood, thus obtaining eternal redemption. For if the blood of goats and bulls, with the sprinkling of the ashes of a heifer, sanctifies those who have been defiled so that their flesh is purified, how much more will the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from dead works to worship the living God. The word of the Lord.
Please stand for the gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. One of the scribes came near and heard them disputing with one another. And seeing that Jesus answered them all well, he asked him, "Which commandment is the first of all?" Jesus answered, "The first is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind, and with all your strengths. The second is this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. Then the scribe said to him, "You are right, teacher. You have truly said that he is one, and besides him there is no other. And to love him with all the heart, and with all the understanding, and with all the strength, and to love one's neighbor as oneself, this is much more important than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices." When Jesus saw that he answered wisely, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." After that, no one dared to ask him any question. The Gospel of the Lord. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Please be seated. An unfortunate feature of life in the last few years, and particularly in this last phase, in the most recent phase of the pandemic, has been anger. There's been quite a bit of anger in public life, some of it on planes, some of it in other venues. A lot of anger has been over masks and vaccine mandates. And it's been particularly noticeable at school board meetings across the country. Many of you may be aware that I live in Douglas County, and in that county, that county has certainly been no exception.
prayers of the people are found on page 5. In peace we pray to you, Lord God, for all people in their daily life and work, for families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone, for this community, the nation, and the world. For the just and proper use of your creation, for the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression, for all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble. For the peace and unity of the Church of God, for all who proclaim the gospel and all who seek the truth, for Michael, our presiding bishop, and Kim, our bishop, for Anna, our pastor, and for all clergy and lay ministers, for all who serve God in his church, for the special needs and concerns of this congregation, especially, and please say with me, Marcus, Richard, Bill, Mike, Peter, Corey, Lou, Leslie, the Anderson family, Allie, Judy, Fran, Denise, Lindsay, the Tice family, Sabina, Allison, and Isaac. Hear us, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. Today, we celebrate the birthdays of Adriana Lalinde Fisher and Bernie Slack. And praise your name forever and ever. We pray for all who have died that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them who put their trust in you. We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. And so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. For your support for this. So we have one other announcement. Sharon would like to talk to us about the craft fair. Oops.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, okay. Our craft fair will be November 13th. We're going to open it from 9 until 4. We have a sign-up sheet in the back for anyone who would like to work on a shift and help us out on that. I think you're going to be pleasantly surprised at all of the wonderful things that are going to be out there for sale. And speaking of surprises, Anna has given us her blessing, which we thank her for, and we are going to open it Friday evening from 6:30 to 8 for our church family for a sneak peek and, of course, lots of purchases. We'll be happy to take your money. We have no problem with that at all. And the other thing I'd like to bring to your attention is we have some great cards that were made by our own Dane Nelson advertising the craft fair. I'd like to give these to the ushers, and if you would like to take a few of them as you leave to pass to your neighbors, friends, co-workers, or whatever, we would really appreciate it. And so that's it. I hope to see lots of faces, and we'll see you on November 13th.
And we have Gwen Jorgensen to speak to us about why St. Martin's.
Yes, I'm real close to right at the four-year mark of attending St. Martin's. The first time I landed here was in 2017. It was on All Saints Sunday, and I had just lost my mom 3 weeks before that. I was very disconnected from churches, not from my faith, but I had moved, both my husband and I had moved my folks like four times over the 4 years preceding that, and it had been an unsettled time. And I was weary and tired. I knew I loved liturgy. I'd followed the Celtic daily prayer for years, even though I'd gone to a lot of evangelical churches. And I knew I liked that, and I thought, oh, I need to go somewhere. And I wasn't even aware that it was All Saints Day that day. And I ended up in a church very close to my home, just coming to absorb what I could, and found really a small but welcoming community. I loved the liturgy. I already knew I would, but I didn't know how much I would. I loved the Word of God rolling over me from the Old Testament, the New Testament, the Psalms. It was really healing, especially that day on All Saints when I was still grieving my mom and my dad 16 months before. So as I went home, you know, I forgot my husband was doing something else that day, and I had just landed here kind of on the spur of the moment. But I went home and told my husband, I want to go there at least through Advent. It's just where I need to be for a while. And so I did, and I kept staying, and I kept staying. And reasons I stayed was I began to really appreciate watching the community, just how you took care of each other. And I kept having that verse come to my mind, see how great their love for one another. And it wasn't like you all didn't have differences, but you took care of each other, and you kept hanging in there. And 2017, you were already in transition. This church was already a church in transition. I think Father Bob was here at that time, and that was great. I learned a lot about the Episcopal tradition at that time. I enjoyed it, and I enjoyed it for reasons. It's interesting to me, all the reasons that Pastor Anna expressed in her homily today are reasons I just loved this community. I didn't see it as a perfect place, wasn't looking for a perfect place, but I saw it as a place where people, regardless of whatever leadership happened to be around, had strived to follow Jesus and love each other and trust God for the rest. And that was really a blessing and a balm to me. I saw it reflected both in the liturgy and your lifestyle, taking care of people, getting rides to church, surgeries, and whatnot. I enjoyed the women's breakfast when I could. I hope I get that back there someday again. I didn't hear this overwhelming gossip that I have known other places. So I love the striving to follow Jesus part of you all, and it's been good. It's been a good place to be, and I'll stay here until the Lord moves us somewhere else. We are always in transition, it seems, but I am thankful that St. Martin's has been here. It's been a blessing.
Thank you. Thank you. I certainly hope the Lord doesn't decide to move you someplace else anytime soon. I realize I failed to mention a couple of things. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Thank you. Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for restoring us in your image and nourishing us with spiritual food in the sacrament of Christ's body and blood.
Amen.
Thank you.